Hello, everybody. I'm Derek Tubbers. Welcome back. We're still on our drive to Pinochet. We crossed into Nevada last week. We're making the run. Running for Pinochet. Yeah. So we're gonna make this trip. Hopefully, we'll wrap it up. I don't see any reason why we wouldn't. We're just crossing Nevada. It's not that big of a state. I think it's bigger than France. Anyway, we're gonna cruise with the sun in our eyes so we can't see a bleeding thing. And hopefully this will get us all the XP we need to then consider what we do about our future here trucking in the Euros. No, in the Americas. goodness, where are we? Oh, okay, I know where we are. Oh, all the braking. All the braking. Excellent. Nothing. Nothing. Still nothing. There we go. I have still not bothered to get anything like Track IR, and I don't think I will. You know, strangely enough, while it might be really cool adding yet another piece of gubbins to my setup, I'm just like, hey look, Highway Patrol, woohoo! Yeah, it's one of the mods we got in here. Got the Nevada Highway Patrol and the California Highway Patrol, but only when you're not in a town. Otherwise, it's the town cops. Town cops. Oh, look, here's another highway patrolman. What are you guys doing? Chasing somebody? Oh, look at that trucker. He's coming around that corner hot. He's like, yeah! Dude, careful. Careful, there's a cop up ahead. Those of you outbound south out of Tonopah, there's a couple bears on the road. Just be advised. All right. I guess it's southbound. I don't freaking know. I'm assuming it's south out of Tonopah. I am speeding through Tonopah. Why? Oh god, I'm gonna get a ticket, aren't I? Oh, I didn't get a ticket for speeding through Tonopah. I'm actually mildly shocked by that, but alright. Really, truck? Oh, because I had it in ninth gear. Ray's Hamburgers. Hamburgers. I think I'm going to have a hamburger today. I do believe that's going to be a thing. Alright, so one thing I'm going to do. I don't need fuel. We're going to go ahead and get fuel. Because again, we're in the desert. And I'm not going to risk it. There we go. I'd rather make sure I have enough fuel than be out in the desert and be like, help. Besides, it cost me $66. All right, so the other thing we're going to do is we're going to stop in this service yard here and get the truck looked at. Because I know we've got some damage to the wheels. The new force feedback is annoyingly loud. There we go. All right. Let's service the truck. What do we got here? Oh, not bad. Just pretty much, it's tires heavily, but everything else not too bad. Okay. Nice. Just out of curiosity, I'm going to look at the upgrade shop. Because we're here. Level 10 gets me that. All right. So that's a better chassis. Don't really care about that. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And that's just new stuff that we don't care about. Yeah. What's that? Ah, that's right. I can get the double calibers. No, the single is fine with me. All right, yeah, let's just leave. All right. Okay, now we gotta get out of here. They should really make this yard bigger. Just saying. All right, I think I can make that cut. Ooh, it's gonna be close. Nah, we'll make it. There we go. Look at that. Nobody coming, that's good. There we go. Yeah, since we're going out in the desert, I think it makes a lot of sense to make sure the truck is fully kit repaired, got a full tank of fuel. And it's just too dangerous, I think, to go running out in the desert without all that. Whoa, I thought that car was gonna broadside me. I'd be like, dude, really? Southwest Resort. Leaving Tonopah. Huh. You cut off those guys, but I'm not going to. Alright, come on, everybody. He's going slow enough. I think I'm gonna go for it. Ah, he was turning anyway. Good. Ha ha. Okay. We're on the road across Nevada. I would love to get a truck, not a camper, not these stupid, like, oh, I've got a motorhome. Yeah, no. I'd like to get a truck, and you know those toppers to the America, you know what I'm, Americans know what I'm talking about. You drop onto the bed of a truck, camper topper thing, you know what I'm talking about, right? But they've got them now that have the pop top, so they're really slimlined unless you pop it up when you're going to go to sleep. I'd totally get one of those, right? And like a crew cab 4x4, right? And just go cruising across the United States. Like, hit every contiguous U.S. state, so all 48 of them. And just, like, never touch the interstate, right? Never. Let's not say never. Unless you have no choice. So if you're, like, somewhere and, you know, the back road is closed or whatever... Dude, really? Thanks. Appreciated that. You know, unless the back road is closed for construction or you know, you done got lost and the only way back in is it, back to where you need to be is by interstate. That kind of thing. But other than that, I totally drive the back roads only. That would be so cool. Like just driving along, taking pictures and visiting like all the national parks and monuments you can find and the state parks and monuments along the way, because that'd be pretty cool too. Yeah, that is my idea of like the perfect, God, what would that take you? Probably a year? Oh yeah, take a year off from work and do that. I wonder if I could swing that. Probably not. You guys would be without videos for an entire year. Ha ha. Because I'd have nothing, I'd have no way to upload anything or edit anything. Yeah. Still, I mean, that would be kind of cool. You know, you read about people who like do like bicycle trips. There's Ram right across America. Bump that, you gibbon. Ram right across America, where you ride your bicycle across the United States. no, thank you. But the idea, when I read about it, I'm like, oh, that's a really cool idea. Mm-hmm. It really is. I like the idea. All right, Dare, would you please stay on the road?
I'm trying already. I'm trying.
All right, when we hit 60 miles an hour here, we're going to put the cruise on so I can take my foot off the gas. There we go. 59, that's fine. And just cruise. Yeah, I wouldn't want a motorhome to do that because there's a lot of national parks where it's more, well, especially out west here, we have a lot of stuff that you're going to be going off-road to get to it anyway. And if I've got myself a nice, you know, 4x4 crew cab rig and a low-profile camper on there, I think it'd be pretty good. Now, there is a place called Earth Roamer. I think that's their name. But they do all the construction here in Colorado, just down the road, actually. And they take a 350 and 450 4x4 chassis and custom build the entire thing. And it is super expensive. I mean, we're talking like $200,000-$300,000 for these custom off-road rigs. I'm just like, I can't justify that. Most people can't justify that. That's silliness. But, I mean, obviously somebody does it, because otherwise this company wouldn't be in business. Still, I'm like, wow, that's insane. Insane. We are now entering Eli. We need to slow down, because... Because, all right, stop the truck. I was pressing buttons trying to find which, I don't remember what half my buttons do still. All right, I don't know what you're doing, but all right, I'm gonna, if you're gonna sit there, I'm gonna go. Oh, this town reminds me of, just this little bit right here, reminds me almost of Leadville, Colorado. Little bit. Not completely, but a little bit. Pretty cool place.
You go someplace cool, Leadville's pretty cool.
Just don't get hurt because their hospital closed.
No medical care.
Well, you do. It's just not a hospital.
Ah, red light.
Red light.
Wow, this is a quicker drive than I thought. Aw, I can't stay at that motel. Ugh. Terrible.
Terrible, I said, terrible.
I wonder if I can pick up something out of this same quarry here in Pinochet. That's neutral, you idiot. Yep, pretty much. I wonder if I can do that. I wonder if I can pick up something out of the same quarry that I'm going into. That's the horn. That's that. Where is my, why have I lost my retarder? I don't know. I'm just going to ignore the whole problem right now. I hope it goes away. Seventh gear sounds good. Alright, that was the worst turn ever. It was because I was like busy trying to stop, so I was shifting, and then it's my excuse, I'm sticking to it. Motel. Another motel I can't go to. Oh, because it's closed. Is it?
No, it's open. Why can't I go there and sleep? Robbery, I tell you. Robbery.
Now,
into the two lane.
What's that?
Looks like a little water pump.
Nah, it can't be a water pump. It's the desert. Yeah, but there are trees here, so that would imply... That would imply... that there is water.
Huh. AutoZone, auto parts, accessories, and advice.
Usually wrong advice, but hey, whatever. I can't tell you how many times I've gone to AutoZone. They've been like, "Oh, you want to do the thing with the stuff," and I'm just like, "No, I just need a light bulb for my car."
You need the upgrade?
No, I don't. I just need the light bulb for my car.
We're almost to our destination. Woohoo! Another Bates Motel. Dun, 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 burned down.
It really does look like the motel from Grand Theft Auto, doesn't it?
It really does.
There, stay on the road, and preferably your side of it.
But I don't wanna.
Yeah, obviously. Alright.
Almost, yeah.
I swear that was supposed to be my returner, but
I've lost it.
I've lost which button on this monstrosity is for the returner. Oh well.
I'll make do.
All right, let's find out why these guys want sand. Let's see if we can guess why they want sand here. Because they're not a quarry so much as they are. Oh, I found the retarder. Apparently, I wasn't pushing it the right way. God. Huh. Huh. There's some sort of manufacturing facility.
Birch. Boom.
All right, let's hope we get out what we want. 445, nope.
Why do you hate me, game?
All right, job market, freighty market, Pinochet. Okay, so both of these are here in where we are. That's going back the way we came, which is, you know, fine. And that's going down that way. All right, let's check the world map and see which one would be more interesting. Really, neither of them. Let's be brutally honest here. Really, neither of them would be all that interesting. Okay. I'm thinking we go down to LA. Because that'll get us closer to El Centro. All right, so let's do that thing. Stockton. No, LA. Yeah. Because that puts us close to El Centro. We can probably pick up something to El Centro. And we should be able to do this relatively quickly. 400, 500. Yeah, we should be able to do this in this episode, and then we can hopefully finally do the thing we want to do. All right. What, truck? Oh.
Starting in ninth gear again, you idiot.
Yeah, well, what can I say? What can I say? Alright. Again, let me just pick up the job since I'm already here. Don't make me go all the way to the entrance. Jeez Louise. It's not so bad here because it's not super far, but my goodness, some of these. Yeah, and she's getting tired. There is a rest stop in Pinochet, but it's a crap one. All right, take that job. We might have to, as much as I don't like the idea, we might have no option but to head back to Eli. Because I think Eli actually has some resting areas. I mean, he's got those motels. Hey, dude. What's up? But we could just try to book it. I think we might try to book it, actually. Clink. All right, let's see here. Yeah, buddy. Looks good. All right. Let's check the map really quick. All right, so I want to take that little loop right there because I do. No, I don't want to do that. How far? Okay, so that's the next rest stop. I'm aiming for that one right there. Yeah. Now, when we get to Vegas, instead of turning here, I'm going to go straight into Vegas and see if, because it would allow us to discover more of Vegas. And then nothing, because everything else is going to be roads that we don't need. Oh, wait, no. If I turn here and go down the slide road to 10, I don't need to do that. Whatever. There, drive the truck. Okay. All right. So we're going to try to book it through Pinochet and make it to the point beyond. Because I think we can do it. I hope we can do it. I mean, if we pass out on the way, it's just pray. Close our eyes and pray. Pretty much. Because technically the town does not have a hotel. So because I don't have a sleeper cab, shouldn't go there. So we're not going to go there. Why are you in, get ninth gear? Nobody's coming. Ugh. Wow, really, Dare? Really? What's up, dude? I wish you could see the AI drivers trying to park up. It'd be amazing. Yep, getting tired. It's all right. We're going to put the pedal down and hope. Because that's all we can do at this juncture. Put the pedal down and pray. Because there's the hotel. It's burned down. Not going to do much with that. So we're just going to have to book it. Yeah. All right, there is a motel right there. No, there isn't. There's no motel. Liar! Liar! It's all right. We're going to make it to this other place. I'm sure of it. I'm sure of it. I hope. I wish that I had the option to turn that stupid thing off. Maybe I do, and I just haven't found the option yet. But I hate that little pop-up. It's like, go away. I don't need you. Darn well aware that I have a sleepy problem. All right. We're just going to... We got the pedal down. Going to be at 65 here in a moment. That guy had an accident. that was Brew back there. No. That place over there is for sale. I don't think so. Alright. Just keep the pedal down and just should be there soon enough, I think. with all of our cement. What is that round thing, I wonder? Ooh. 40 mile an hour corner. That actually looks like a 40 mile an hour corner. Look at this, guys. Look at this. We made it. Bet you didn't expect me to actually make it. To be honest, I didn't think I'd make it either. Where's the turnoff? Right here. Okay. Do not enter. Screw you. There we go. All right, look at this. How perfect. Didn't think we'd actually make it, did ya? Stop truck. There. There we go. Slip time. Woohoo! We made it. Parking brake off. Go. Nope, not ninth gear. Don't do that. Look at the giant duck! Oh my god, the giant duck! The giant duck will kill us. The giant duck is going to kill us all. Run away from the giant duck. Ducks are evil. Ducks are evil. Ducks are stupid is what they are. I mean, man, they got pawned bad by Ikthomi. Alright, let's go. Alright. Now we remember that when it tells us to turn in Vegas, we're going to ignore that turn and go straight. We probably could have fueled up, but hey, whatever. We are now leaving Wanzing Creek. Okay. Glad that creek was there. Saved us from disaster. Disaster. There's a truck behind us. There, I was like, there's something back there. Oh, come on, truck. We just need a few hundred more experience points. I was just a turn here? Really? I thought I was going to go straight. No, I am going to turn here. Because this takes us towards Vegas. Because straight takes us towards... Yeah, towards Tonopah. Okay, that's the back road to Tonopah. That? I have no idea what that is. It's too dark to see. Speaking of, brights. Whew. Oh, come on, truck. Pull, pull, pull. Let's go. Ooh, look, satellite dishes. Is that the very large radio telescopic array? Ah, yeah, I think it is. Oops, sorry. Yeah, I think that's the very large mobile telescopic array. Ah, that's where we made first contact. Ah, that was actually a good movie. If you've not watched Contact, you should totally go watch Contact. Totally worth it. I really enjoyed it. Yeah. Was that a plane over there? Were my eyes deceiving me, or was there a plane, or maybe it was a UFO? An UFO! If you're a dog, an UFO is an unidentified foul odor. Alright. We got the hammer down. It's 2 a.m. in the morning. We're gonna hope there's no cops, because we're just gonna push this truck all the way up. Not like all the way up really means a heck of a lot, let's be honest. We don't exactly have the most powerful truck there is. And there we go. Tractors crossing. We'll deliver to him eventually. Ha ha. Hopefully, this little jaunt down to L.A. Ooh, looks like we're coming up to Vegas. What happens in Vegas usually shows up in the police blotter in Vegas. 30 miles an hour. I don't think so. We might have to slow down for that guy. Oh, no, we don't. Don't you dare. I knew he was going to try. We're just holding on to 70 miles an hour because I don't see any reason not to right now. I mean, I'm sure there's a reason. I just don't know what that reason is currently. Whoa, other than that part right there, that almost threw the truck. Alright, now we're getting into Vegas where there's going to be stoplights. But if I keep the hammer down... Well, that light's red! Oh, truck. Oh, thank goodness you have good brakes. Whew. Yeah. Nice. Well, we've made it into Vegas already, people. So that's a good thing. Of course, now we got red lights everywhere, but what do you know? What's up, yuppie? Ooh, airplane. Shark-free aquarium. Okay. I thought most people went to aquariums to see sharks. Is that a new thing? We don't want to see sharks. They scare us in the aquarium. I don't know where that weird British accent came from. Not even British. I don't know what the heck accent that was. Oh, we got a green light. Of course, right as the truck stops, the light turns green. Look at this road. Look at this road. Man, you need roads these big. Good lord. Oh, is this the back way around the strip? Or are we on the strip? No, we're not on the strip. There's no way we're on the strip. The strip is where that big tower thing was. Truck, I could use you stopping. Huh. Don't know where we are. Other than that, we're in Vegas. That's all I know for sure. For sure. Right here. There we go. Find the gear, Dare. I don't know where it is. Yeah, it's quite obvious. You don't know where it is. Hey, look, there's the monorail. Yeah, the monorail. It's just crap, because it doesn't actually take you all that far. Alright, I'm going to need to be all the way over here. Really? You can't turn for me? Is that a limo? Do I spy with my little eye a limousine? I think I do. I do spy a limousine. Hey, limousine. That's got to be one of the worst jobs ever, driving a limo in Vegas. All the petulant little brats who are like, oh, I want a limousine and I'm going to be, I'm amazing and I'm whatever. Urch. Hotel. Bus. Farland. It needs to be Greyhound, but whatever. What's up? Oop, green light. It's very quiet this morning at 3:30 in the morning. Not actually. Except for those people who are apparently getting out of a casino. Well, that's not a surprise, now is it? Alright. We've got 285 miles on the tank. I'm of split mind about whether I want to stop for fuel or not. I'm thinking we can stop for fuel later because we'll be getting into an area where fuel will be more prevalent than out on the out in the desert. Cop, are you actually going to go this way with me? Man! Oh, why are you stopping, you idiot?
Oh my god, you are such an idiot!
Why is there a stop sign here? There should never be a stop here. I'm sorry, but that's bull. Plane. Oh, plane disappeared. Oh, it disappeared because it went by my visor. Never mind. Oh, yeah. Look at that merge. Yeah. That trucker just yelled at me. I don't know. I had the Delta V for that. I had the Delta on that. Alright, let's wind her up and get on out of town. Shouldn't take us too much longer to get to our destination. It looks like it's another construction site, side of the road type thing. It's a long shipment to ship that, but alright, whatever. Prim! Prim. Makes me think of Fallout New Vegas and how much I dislike that game. Yeah. Just not, I don't know. There's something about New Vegas, I just never liked it. Even modded, I never liked it. I should try it again. Probably pull some mods out, but I should try it again. It's like I haven't bought Fallout 4 because all I've heard is bad stuff about it.
And it's so expensive.
I mean, Bethesda games are huge, but oh, it's so expensive. And I'm just like, you know, dude, seriously? What is wrong with you? Jeez. You're going to get run over by 40,000 pounds of cement. I mean, talk about cement shoes, cement underwear. 40,000 pounds of cement crushing you, make you go squishy, squishy. Your stupid van, probably even a Chevy van. Sorry, I hate Chevy vans. I don't know why, mind you. I can't remember why I hate Chevy vans. I hate modern Ford vans too, by the way. The Econolines, blech, modern ones, crap. The old ones weren't bad. Even when my family's 1981 E150 with a 351, even when that thing's head gasket sprung a leak, and that thing could still pull, that thing was a hoss. We let that thing limp along until we traded in for another one, slightly newer, the 351. And that thing went on forever. I think my parents still have a 250. An E250. And that thing's a hoss too. It's got an oil leak, but it's a hoss. But these newfangled vehicles, you know, they're just gonna break down as soon as you sneeze. It's like if I get a truck, I'm getting like an 80s to early 90s truck. Because that was back when they made the trucks to last. Plus, you can actually work on the suckers. Nowadays, it's like, oh, you want to work on it? Well, you need an electrical engineering degree and these $1,000 pieces of equipment. No, thank you. Oop, lights went off. Should be pretty close to a destination based on the fact that we're passing Barstow right now. There are these guys hitting their brakes. Oh, it's 55 now. Watch me not hit my brakes. Because, seriously, why? I'll just cruise through here at, what am I doing? 70-ish. It's alright, I just got concrete. Ain't no thing. Ain't no thing. As I say, not a way station, just a gas station. Cruise by. Flash like a gang sign of some sort. I don't know. Like, how do you flash Hello Kitty as a gang sign? Oh my goodness. If you want to see the strangest music video ever, I mean, I'm sure there's stranger ones, but it's a relatively recent strange music video. Check out Avril Lavigne's Hello Kitty. That is weird. Though it's like it's a songworm. It gets in your brain and you're like rocking along to it. I can't remember the words, but like I've got the beat in my brain right now and it's like, okay, yeah, this is pretty cool. Yeah. Avril Lavigne was pretty darn good back in the day. She's kind of weird now. I will say Never Grow Up was a pretty good song. But nothing. Screw you. Speed cameras here. I will say that Never Growing Up, that's a pretty good song. But nothing beats Skater Boy. Nothing beats Skater Boy. And the music video is pretty darn cool, too. Haha, you should check that out. She's a really good artist, so totally worth a check out if you like that kind of music. I know a lot of people don't. For I don't know what reason. Oh, it's a downhill. Slow down, they say to the truckers. Do they? Because I think I'm speeding up. I think I need to slow down, though, because I do need to make this exit. Whoo. All right, to the exit we go. I'm running out of fuel. Well, I just passed the fuel station, so I don't really care. Nope, not doing that. Whoa, dude. I need to get over. Thank you, jackbutt. 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 All right, turn in here. Oh, go. All right, fine. Don't go. I don't really care. Ah, the AI still doesn't know how to drive. All right. How is this LA? I don't even know. But apparently it is, so we'll go with it. I guess it's like the very far reaches of Los Angeles. Ugh. Alright, where are you on it? Seriously? Wow, what is this long string of, like, super simple, parking jobs? Ow.
Go. Boom.
Be what we need. You're kidding, right? Oh yeah, it's what we needed. Workhorse. All right, we need to get our last ADR. What is our last ADR? Flammable solids. That sounds like a good thing for us to haul. Let's haul it. Ha ha.
Yeah.
Let's go in here. New upgrades available. Let's see what we got. For the pita belt, we get a stand-up sleeper, the 6x4 long 220 in a platinum interior. For the Kenwealth, we get the mid-roof, the long, the interior. We get the studio sleeper, the long, and that. Okay. Cool. We got 54,000. We're making 68 grand a day. Time to go to the bank. We're going to take out a $400,000 loan. Whoo, doggy, that's expensive. All right, so first things first. Garage. Sacramento. I need to upgrade. There we go. Upgrade Sacramento. 180 grand. Yes, please. Nice. Ooh, we're teleporting. Ooh, look at our garage. Look at that improvement. Look at that truck headquarters. Looks pretty good. We got the lift out in the back now. It's not a dirt field. That's an improvement. Yeah, that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. All right, excellent. All right, so now truck manager. No, driver manager. That. Can I? No. Yeah, this. I want this truck. Can I make this truck? No. What I do is I hire a driver. Yeah, recruitment agency. All right, let's hire somebody. Okay, I'm hiring somebody. Pierre. Oh, good Lord, Pierre. I kind of want Pierre just for the look on his face. Yes, you're getting Pierre. That is like... All right, Pierre, you're going to be located here. You'll be located there. Okay. Yes. All right. Now, I'm going to go to the truck dealers. Kenworth. Oh, there's one right here. Oh, well, all right. Let's go visit. Let's visit the dealer. Yes. All right. There's our... Let's customize this guy. All right. Yes, that's fine. There we go. There's a bigger truck for us. All right, we're going to put the 455 horsepower engine in there. We're going to put the... Oh, I really want the retarder. So we're going to keep the 13 speed on this guy. Inside, we got the modern or the classic. Going with modern because it's cheaper. We'll keep it in this color for now, but we're actually going to put a new color on it eventually. All right. I want that mirror or that? I want that mirror because it looks better. I want that mirror. Okay. Good, 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 good. All right. Let's see. What do we got around here? It's like, what do I click? Exhaust. Standard exhaust or plain stacks? Ooh, we can go a little bit cheaper. But I do like those exhaust. You know what? That'll be our first upgrade, but it'll save us money by dropping those. So we're going to drop those right now. Basic air filters, yes. Cabin panel. Oh, $220 for that. No. Okay, well, that'll be our next upgrade. Standard sun shield or blind mount? No, we're going to have a standard sun shield because we really do need one. Okay, I want those, but not right now. I want something like that, but not right now. What's this? Turbo wing! No. What's this? Metal deflector. Ooh, looks nice. We'll buy it later. Bumper shield. All that stuff is really cool, but we're going to, again, that'll be something we'll get later. No, we're not going to mess with that. Roadmaster tires. No, we're going to stay with the Dynex for now. Mirrors duty or mirrors double? Oh, I want the double mirrors because it's a safety thing with the extra mirror. Yeah. Okay, so interior. What's that? Oh, that's the mirrors. Okay. That's that. Okay, what are you? Air filter. Okay. All right. So this cost me 147,000. Okay. Confirm. Okay, we're not going to trade in. We're going to straight purchase this truck. Purchase. Would you want to drive? Yes. Goes there. Oh, that's the Peterbilt. All right, so the... There. Okay. All right. Right away. Okay, good. Oh, yeah. Here's our new truck. I know all of you have been waiting for me to get something like this. But we're not done with it quite yet. No. We still have money. And because we still have money, we got one more thing we got to do with it. It is a pretty nice looking truck, though. She's a big un. Much bigger than that day cab. But that's all right. The new guy can drive the day cab. All right. Okay. All right. Here we go. Nice new engine note. Okay, service yard. Because we got to get something done to this truck. Come on, truck. I just wanted to roll into the position I wanted to be in. All right. Now, I wanted to do this here instead of in the regular thing. I want to go here, and I want to go to... Where is it? No, that's not what I want. Do I have to unlock the bloody thing? Oh my good lord, that's horrendous. That's not much better. Okay. Okay. Oh, that's the split line right there. All right. So what if I put the split line in like a blue? Like that. Okay. So what are you? Ah, you're the fender wells. Oh, that's actually pretty not a bad color for the fender wells, is it? And then... God, that's horrendous. Leave. Do you want to cancel all your modifications? Yes. The thing that I was expecting was not there. So I'll deal with that later. All right. There we go. Our new rig, guys. Ha ha ha. All right, so we got a new truck, we got a driver, we've got a heavy loan. I don't even know where we are. Oh well. Shut the engine down for now. No use wasting fuel. There we go. All right, there we go. New truck, studio sleeper, so we can now sleep wherever we want. We don't have to worry about it. I mean, technically we sort of did anyway, but that's not the point. Freighting market. We are in LA's, so we can get stuff all over the place, which is pretty... Oh, good. We can run up all the way to Reading. price. Yeah. Yep, we can run TVs all the way up to Reading. We'll probably do that next time. Because why not? It gets us $13,000. It's the high pay. The high pay is $17,000, so it's not like we're losing anything. In fact, it's even on the first page. Oh, wait. That's Winnemucca to LA, you idiot. It's the other direction. Oh, never mind. It's not on the first page. I lied. Anyway. God. All right. Until then, remember, drive carefully around trucks, especially big trucks. Even small trucks. Just basically drive carefully. But these trucks will make you go squishy, squishy. You don't want to be a squishy. Until next time. Bye, everybody.